This one is another follow-up from a video that I did last year, which we'll go into it shortly. Now, I had a little bit of a hiccup with this one because there were some parts that were missing, but I found a solution while I was editing and I decided to have two narrators on to narrate the video. And mainly, the main narrator is Turbine, who has volunteered to narrate this video while he's off for Christmas. Turbine, thank you so much, and I'm sorry if some of the parts were missing. But the second narrator who jumped in to help at the very last minute was DK. And DK, thank you so much for helping us out. I'm truly, truly grateful. So you guys are in for a real treat today, two narrators. And until then, I will leave you in their capable hands as we enjoyed the video of the SS traffic.
As a quick disclaimer, I might end up butchering some of the names featured in here, so if we mispronounced any of the names in here, let us know in the comments below. SS Traffic, White Star's Act of Tendership. On the 10th of April 1912, two tender ships carried 291 passengers while the new White Star liner, the RMS Titanic, docked outside of port before resuming her journey to New York, where she would make her final port of call in Queenstown, Ireland, the following day. The two Cherbourg tender ships that carried the passengers onto the liner named the SS Nomadic and the SS Traffic. Last year, a video on the life and career of the SS Nomadic was covered. To watch, head over to the card above to click on the link. This time, we will be touching on the Nomadic's sister ship, the SS Traffic. The SS Traffic is the least known out of the tender ship, but her story is just as fascinating as the Nomadic. From sailing down to Cherbourg with the Olympic following her sea trials to being sunk in the English Channel, this is the Traffic story.
The SS Traffic and the SS Nomadic were built for supposes of transport passengers, baggage, and mail in Cherbourg, France for ocean liners while the liners were on their voyages on the transatlantic route. The full story of the SS Traffic began in 1907 when the tender ship's company, the White Star Line, established a regular stop at the umbrella of Cherbourg. This was part of the company's new transatlantic route, where liners would carry passengers from Southampton to New York instead of Liverpool to New York. Now, to them, it would have made sense as since the start of the 20th century, Cherbourg has become an essential stopover for German and British liners who are traveling between the UK, the United States, and Europe. In 1909, the White Star Line began to build a new dimension in a ferry terminal. These were built to accommodate passengers who would board the liners via special trains from the Gare Saint-Lazare train station in Paris. But because large liners like the Olympic class were unable to dock at the port due to the shallow water, it was decided that tender ships were needed to transport passengers and luggage from the umbrella Cherbourg to the ocean liners. That was the evolution of the construction of both the SS Nomadic and the SS Traffic. Both tenders were designed by Lord Parry, who was the director of the Harland and Wolff shipyards, and his nephew, Thomas Andrews Jr. Both men were the two of the three designers who were responsible for the construction of the RMS Olympic, Titanic, and the HMHS Britannic. With the approval from the president of the White Star Line, J Bruce Ismay, the early stages of constructing the Nomadic and Traffic began. Under the number of 423, the keel of the SS Traffic was laid on the 22nd of December 1910 on slipway number 1 near the direction of architect Roderick Chisholm and Thomas Andrews Jr. The Traffic was built next to the Nomadic and another tender ship, the Patriotic. While the Nomadic would transport first and second class passengers, the purpose of the Traffic was to transport third class passengers, baggage, and mail. From surviving pictures of the tender in the 20th century and in comparison to the modern pictures of the SS Nomadic, the SS Traffic was designed at 233 feet and 6 inches long and 37 feet and 2 inches wide. She also had a gross tonnage of 1,273 and a maximum speed of 12 knots. Inside, she would have comfortable interior facilities and she had electric conveyors that were put in place on both of her bow and stern for loading mail and baggage. She was also designed to have a chamois colored funnel, a black hull, and a red keel. She would have a capacity to accommodate around 1,000 people. The SS Traffic was launched on the 27th of April 1911, 2 days after the launch of the Nomadic, and nearly 1 month before the launch of the RMS Titanic.
On the 18th of May, the SS Traffic had her sea trials, and after passing them, she made her way to Cherbourg, a site of Nomadic in the Olympic. A trio departed on their 31st, and then she and Nomadic made their way to Cherbourg, where they arrived on the 3rd of June, where she and a Nomadic would transport passengers from the New York Express train, luggage and mail, from the port to the Olympic, where she would depart from New York on the 14th of June. However, J. Bruce Ismay wasn't satisfied with the traffic's performance and requested changes to the tender ship before the next ferrying. By the Olympic's return trip, improvements had been made to the tender ship. On the 10th of April 1912, after seeing four tall funnels sailing towards the port and hearing a 21-gun salute fired from the military forts, the traffic and Nomadic transported passengers onto the Olympic sister ship, the Titanic. On board the Titanic, there were 102 passengers. On the 11th, the traffic would transfer third-class passengers to another White Star liner, the Adriatic. Days later, the Titanic sank with a loss of over 1,500 people. Among the dead was Thomas Andrews. Following the sinking, the traffic and Nomadic flew their flags at half-mast when their crews solemnly welcomed the RMS Olympic on her return voyage from New York. The crew also wore black ties as a sign of mourning. Then, while in port, crew members of both tender ships went on strike following the lead of the crew of the RMS Olympic while she was docked in Southampton. The protest in Cherbourg lasted for a short period, and as a result, additional lifeboats were added to the RMS Olympic and the tender ships. During the First World War in April 1917, the traffic and Nomadic were requisitioned by the French Navy as auxiliary minesweepers. They were taken to Saint-Nazaire, where both tenders ferried missions of American troops in Brest. They would serve as minesweepers until 1919. The traffic resumed passenger service in the 1920s, but in 1927 she was sold to the transshipment company. She continued to serve as a tender ship for larger vessels. In June 1929, the traffic collided with the RMS Homeric, where she sustained damage to the starboard side of her hull. An inquiry took place following the incident, and in conclusion, it was agreed that the traffic was notoriously difficult to handle due to her propellers. She was given new propellers that were produced by Harland and Wolff and were fitted in October 1929. 2 months later, the traffic was involved in another collision with the Minnewaska of the Atlantic Transport Line. There was a little damage. In 1934, the traffic and Nomadic were both sold again to the Cherbourgsky Towing and a Rescue Company. In this selling by the company, both tender ships were renamed, with the traffic's new name being the Enquires Rebelle. But for not to confuse things, we are going to continue naming the ship the Traffic. After the outbreak of the Second World War, the French Navy again requisitioned the traffic into a mine layer under the registration of X-23.
As a mine layer, the traffic would have had the responsibility to deploy naval mines that would be detonated if a ship came into close contact in case the enemy came to invade the entry into Cherbourg Harbor. But when the Nazis invaded France in June of 1940, the traffic was scuttled, refurbished, and used as a coastal patroller. However, the Nazis were disappointed about her performance due to her speed, and she could only run at 6 knots. On the 17th of January 1941, the traffic was torpedoed and sunk by the British Royal Navy while patrolling in the English Channel.
After her sinking, she was raised, but because of the damage from the torpedo, it was decided that the traffic was no longer capable of sailing. The traffic was scrapped at Cherbourg not long after. The story of the SS Traffic is a long and engaging tale of courage and tragedy, but despite being long gone, her legacy will live on through her sister ship, SS Nomadic, who is thankfully resting in front of the Titanic Belfast Museum. To this date, she is the last remaining White Star Line vessel to exist today.